Hello! In this tutorial, we used a new principled volume node in Blender for fire and smoke simulations. First, we need a basic understanding of the principled volume node. Let me just quickly create a simple scene with a monkey head in the center and the light in the back. I create a new material for the monkey, remove the surface, and add the principled volume node to the volume output. Before the principled volume node, we had to add a volume scatter and a volume absorption node together. The properties of these two old nodes can now be found in the new node. The color, density, and anisotropy settings of the scatter node are here, the color of the absorption node is here, and this density attribute now controls both scattering and absorption, just like this kind of setup. We know that we can also plug an emission shader into the volume output. The two properties of the emission shader, color and strength, can be found in the principled volume node right here. If we like to use a black body color temperature as our input for the emission color, we can instead use the black body intensity and temperature right here. These three attribute properties are text inputs and come in very handy for smoke simulations because we don't need separate attribute nodes anymore, at least for simple volume materials. Now let's see this in action with a smoke simulation. I move the monkey to a different layer and create a cube, scale it up a little and make this our smoke domain with adaptive domain switched on and 64 divisions. Then I create a simple torus, move it down and scale it down a little and make it our smoke flow object for fire plus smoke. Other than that, I simply keep all the default settings. I also create a force field wind, move and rotate it a bit, and set the strength to 3 and noise to 1, just so we get a bit more interesting smoke. I set the length of the animation to 50 frames and hit play to get the simulation going. Now, when I switch this to rendered view, we see nothing, because we still need to create a material for the smoke domain object. Using the principled volume node, this is really easy, because its default values are already perfectly set up for fire and smoke using the density attribute for the smoke and the temperature attribute for the flames. By default, we get the smoke only, but when I turn up the black body intensity, we also get the flames. Now we can play with the density, the intensity, and the temperature to create something that looks nice. You can see that we have a cycles volumetric material for fire and smoke all from a single node, where before we had to create a rather complicated node tree. One thing I like to do for the flame though is give it a bit of color variation to make it burn brighter where it is emitted and darker at the tip of the flame. Of course, we can still do this using the principled volume node also. I simply create the color ramp for the flame colors I want. Now I use the good old attribute flame as the driving factor. Now I switch off the black body intensity, plug this color ramp into the emission color and turn up the emission strength. The flame attribute is actually 1, where the flame is the hottest, so we can simply flip our color ramp. So the blue is now down here. Then it fades to white, yellow, red, and so on. If I make the smoke really, really dense now, we notice that the flame sort of disappears. That's because we have smoke everywhere, which we can see when I switch off the flame emission for a moment. The heavy smoke down here covers up the flames. We could simply crank up the emission strength to counteract that, or, maybe better, we subtract the flame from the smoke, so we have much less smoke where the flames are, and use that for our density input. As you can see, the principled volume node gives us a very quick, usable result for fire and smoke simulations right out of the box. And we are still free to tweak everything to our liking, but with a much less complicated node tree. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more Blender videos. Thank you for watching. See you soon!